Good afternoon, Boomi fans, and welcome back to beautiful Dallas, Texas. We're here at Boomi World 2025. My name is Savannah Peterson. Very delighted to be co-hosting here with Paul today. Yeah. Paul, we had the best day yesterday.
We really did. Really exciting times. Lots of product announcements, lots of tech stack and advancements. Yeah. Pretty cool stuff.
We had some laughs. We got to talk about nails.
We
did. It was great. Manny even liked my Manny. It was fabulous.
Awesome.
Really excited to bring back a super VIP CUBE alum. You might as well be over here co-hosting with us as well. Ed, thank you so much for taking time today.
Oh, thanks for having me again.
Hey, our pleasure. I look forward to chatting with you every year at Boomi World. You just got off the stage doing the keynote. Can you give us a couple highlights from what you shared today?
Yeah, so I shared a little bit more in depth around our roadmap and the things that we're focused on from a API management and integration and automation, data management perspective, and of course got into some details around our AI management solution and our agent studio, so it was pretty fun.
That is pretty fun. I want to talk to you a little bit about the agent designer tool.
Yeah.
Can you tell us what that is and how that works?
Yeah, so the agent designer is a low-code way that allows our users to build agents on top of essentially the connectivity and the fabric that they built with the Boomi platform today. But it also allows developers or citizens or normal human beings, citizens, the rest of you, not me, but everyone else, to build agents in a low-code way across our platform. It's pretty popular. We're just announcing it as generally available, but we've already had hundreds of customers build thousands of agents on this platform.
33,000, right? Something like that?
Well, we deployed 33,000 agents from Boomi AI, that's helping our customers build and automate things in the platform. These agents our customers are building are solving real business problems. One example that we implemented ourselves is within my team, we're drinking our own champagne. We have a product management use case. We get all kinds of information, unstructured data, presentations, spreadsheets of customers asking us for things, and we have official channels as well. We use Boomi to automate connecting and collecting all that information, and then we have an agent on top of us that helps our product managers understand our customers' needs and actually build product requirements documents, put it back into systems, that sort of thing. So we're supercharging and super making our product manager superhuman as well.
Yeah, what was really, really cool was not to be confused with the May 24th announcement day, the GA day, right? Because that's what was coming out of yesterday's discussion, a lot of product launches. But what was really cool was the theme yesterday was reducing complexity, right? It was all about taking it down to the level of operational efficiencies, making things work faster, delivering productivity, creating those agents, and that one platform really helps do that. So like when you look at your designer agent, an agent designer, sorry, that really does, I like what you said, the citizen, right? Yep. When I cover app dev, and that's where the focus I look at, you know, we see a lot of applications being created, AI being ingested in or being used in applications to the tune of 500 to 1,000 just at the edge locations alone in the next 2 years. Citizen developers are going to have to be the ones that do it, and your compliance and regulation in place allows for that citizen developer to do their jobs. Is that accurate?
Yeah, that's right. I mean, a lot of when it comes to connecting, automating, integrating, et cetera, to be honest, a lot of that's commoditized in the market anyway, right? Like you connect A to B. The power of Boomi's platform itself is the governance, compliance, the guardrails. When you introduce when you want to bring all these concepts in your enterprise, you know, the IT organization and CISOs want to know that my citizens, my developers, everyone is building something in a compliant way. So we focus at that lens in terms of, okay, if you're going to build agents, do it in a low-code way, you get them done very quickly, but we have the agent control tower that then captures them and puts them and puts those agents in a registry of sorts that give the security folks the ability to manage, govern them, make sure they're doing things appropriately in the organization. And that's just what we followed across our entire platform, whether it's APIs and API management and database connectivity and our data management story, just the security and compliance is extremely important to us and what we bring to our customers.
It's table stakes, too. I mean, especially as we're scaling with the amount of data that's going to be coming through these systems.
Yeah, and most of these, these AI technologies that are coming out today are very, very bespoke, right?
And
a lot of the market is focused on the fascination with the tools and technology itself, not about the outcomes and the way they really run in a business environment, which is fine, innovators will do that. But for us, we're warning our customers of, okay, it's great to do these and innovate, but when you're putting these things in production, you got to be careful about what you're exposing your production systems to out in the field, whether it's your own employees or worse, the public.
Yeah, and you're still accountable for it, right?
Right.
And the other thing I was thinking about when I was talking about the citizen developer, you're making it easy for the citizen to develop the lines of business to do their jobs, right, get their jobs done, but you're also accelerating the innovation for the professional developer, right? And that gives you the complexity that if you need to use those new tool sets, or you're connecting in different agents, or get bridges into the conversation of MCP, right? So we look at agent to agent, we look at MCP and the different connectivity. That's where the professional developers are looking at building out how these systems are all connected together. And so I know you have some announcements there during the keynote, so.
Yeah, so what's very important to note is that everything we're building in our platform, particularly around AI, is not proprietary to Boomi. We're not inventing new LLMs, we're not inventing new ways of interoperating. We are a platform that's integrating all of the above. So if you want to bring your own large language models, you want to bring your own MCP servers, you want to bring your own data sources that are on AWS or Microsoft, et cetera, we look at ourselves as an open, composable platform. Yep. So all we are doing is simplifying the complexity around how you tie all these together and giving an experience that allows you to assemble the business outcomes with these technologies. So professional developers that are coders, et cetera, they can take all these tools, put them in place, build some foundational pieces, and then you can use the Boomi platform to unlock these in terms of delivering solutions within an organization, and particularly around MCP. I get a lot of questions around that. How do you support MCP? Do you support it? What are you backing? Are you thinking about ACP, MCP, A to A, agent to agent, et cetera? All of the above. Boomi historically has sat at the intersection of all of the different standards, et cetera, I talked about on stage earlier. This thing, I've been in it long enough, I've seen these cycles. When you go B2B, like business to business communications, all of these standards popped up, but people, kind of centered around X12 EDI, I'm going to date myself here, but X12 for the States, EDIFACT in Europe. Sure. We're just following the same things, and we will support all of them for our customers so that when there's winners in the market, meaning markets kind of converge on one, then we'll go there. We are reading MCP is super popular. My developers are prototyping all over the place. They love it. So we are embracing MCP in two lanes. One, MCP and MCP server capabilities out in front of the Boomi platform so that agents and agentic processes can interface with the Boomi platform itself to do things with Boomi. Yep. And also in each of the pillars and the roadmaps I covered where MCP plays in terms of for API management, we're offering an MCP gateway capability to protect your APIs and things from MCP servers and agentic workflows and those types of things, all the way down to integration, bridging the gap with MCP and others. So we've got a lot coming. And for those who may be listening that may have missed the keynote, one, you can catch it live. We did it on LinkedIn. But also, we will do quarterly product roadmaps where we go out and we're transparent with our customers exactly what we're adding. So if they have any questions on the roadmap, they can find it on our website.
It's exciting.
It is exciting. Y'all are kind of like the container store. You get everything organized and very visible and easy to discover. And like as you were describing all of that, I was like, ooh, this is like a very well organized room or situation. But that's exactly what you're doing for businesses. You know, it was kind of fun, Ed, when I was looking back at our transcript from last year, I genuinely think you and I might have had the first conversation about agentic AI and agents on theCUBE, period. Yeah. And I learned yesterday, I didn't realize that Steve came up with the term, or is credited with being the first person to say agents. So y'all have really been on the front lines, quite literally.
100%. It's been such a pleasure working with Steve the last couple of years, because he and I work so closely together on our product roadmap innovation. We talk to each other literally daily. He's always challenging me with new ideas. I'm giving him ideas back. And yes, AI agents, I go back to, we had a board meeting a couple of years ago, and I was presenting along with Steve with our board these concepts around, okay, large language models give you information, but they don't do things, they can't act, they're just giving you information as a user. We believe that we can interface that and allow large language models to act. And that's where agents and the agent idea for us was born. And it was a discussion with our board that Steve and I then took, and we were focusing on, because our board was concerned when we brought that, wait, what about governance? You can't just let large language models run rampant within an organization. So they challenged us first with that messaging, and we came up with the products that then protect and govern across the organization itself. So yes, we were the first to talk about these things. It's so cool to see it to come to fruition in the market. And little old Boomi, but hey, we're leading the charge, so.
Yeah, well, one of the things I was noticing at the keynote is the announcements and the consumption of the information that you're putting out there. The marketplace, the Boomi marketplace, really is a place not just for Boomi, but also for the partner ecosystem. And I know that when we walked on the floors here and talking to the partners, your partner ecosystem is enabling for success for organizations to, you know, innovate and move forward and take that modernization approach. Can you talk a little bit about the marketplace and where that's going?
Yeah, so we've had what we've called a catalog for a period of time. It is discover.boomi.com. We're evolving it to marketplace.boomi.com, particularly with this agentic movement that we're seeing here. We enabled this marketplace now to publish agents, not just integration recipes and other assets, but actually create agents. And we actually put out a goal internally leading up to this event. We use this as like kind of a line in the sand to say, how many agents, real agents, can we get our partners and our communities to build? And we've set a goal for 100, because it was only a couple of months, we were in early access and here, and our partners, and along with our team members, delivered over 200 of these agents
in just literally
a couple of weeks. And we ran an agent, I know, and we ran, and these are real agents, and I'll give you some examples. You know, we ran a hackathon for partners to kind of prompt that. We have one partner that built a financial close series of agents that work together and help augment a human. So finance teams who are trying to close their quarters faster, I know there's other tools to do this, but they've agentified this on our platform that helps the different divisions within finance validate the data within the financial systems, push to the next stage and allow agents to accelerate that, because some companies take weeks or months, if you're not in good shape, to close your books at a quarter. But that is one example. And there's so many more I unveiled that, like, I think there was 16 of them on stage earlier today, because where our customers are now, and this is why the marketplace is so important for our partners to showcase what they're thinking about, because most customers that I'm meeting with today are, okay, we understand the pieces of your platform, but help us as integrators, traditional integrators, dream about how I can agentify things in the platform. And this marketplace is a treasure chest of just ideas that our customers can install and run. The future of that is we are now going to open it wide open. We're going to make it easier for partners to publish. And then the reason we chose Marketplace now instead of Catalog is we're going to work towards monetization so we can share some of the revenue with our partners around these as they get installed.
Awesome. Gosh, I can't believe how fast everything's moving right now, too. It's super impressive and it's so exciting. It's so fun to get to see it all. Talk to us a little bit about the OEM embedded program.
Yes, so OEM. OEM and embedded in partnerships is actually a very large part of our business. We've been doing this for years, and where things are going, but we've done it under traditionally the classic integration and automation scenarios. We have a concept of integration packs, and a lot of our partners that OEM our technology use us as the backbone for connecting all of their systems. But we've partnered with our channel team from product to our sales organization to say, we have a real opportunity here with this evolution to an agentic world, where we can really invest and add more capabilities to API enable our platform, make it more embeddable, and bring this to our partners in a more scalable way. And scale, to be honest, is not an issue. We have one partner that's delivered over 200,000 connections and with their customers as an OEM embedded solution already. We're just building on top of that in terms of letting our partners now leverage our technology to embed agents in their applications through the Boomi platform as well. So, vendors out there who are trying to keep up with some of the other large vendors who are announcing all of these agent capabilities, we can bring that in an embedded way and help our partners through their APIs or an MCP server agentify their applications. And the way I talked about it on stage, it's not just for partners. Our customers can think of this as an OEM opportunity as well, meaning they're building applications, they're giving experiences to their users or their customers. They can also embed and take advantage of these in their environments as well.
The OEM embedded area is phenomenal, right? It's awesome as a business model, but you really need to capitalize on the branding, right? You need to let people know that you're under the cover somewhere, in that case. Because, a lot of people know that there's technology. Because it's kind of a best kept secret almost, right?
Yeah.
And that's something that you really need to kind of get out there in the market.
Yes, I agree, it is a challenge. But we have some amazing partners, like ServiceNow, for example, who joined Steve on stage yesterday. Yeah. Paul Phipps joined him, and they're an example of ServiceNow embeds our technology as an OEM partner of ours. And because we are such a strong partner and we provide them with such value, they're willing to shout it from the stage, right?
Awesome.
And Steve joined their events, and QAD is the same thing. They joined us yesterday as well. So that's some of the way we get the word out there. We do have some subtle ways where we put powered by in there to give the end users some of the insight. Um, but but yeah.
No, it's awesome. We were just at Knowledge last week with ServiceNow covering, and it was cool. They were very excited that we were coming here to hang out with you. Yeah. You can tell how collaborative the partner ecosystem is right now. It's a really unique time for that, I think. I've got one final question for you, Ed.
Yes.
When we're hanging out at Boomi World 2026, what do you hope to be able to say then that you can't yet say today?
I'm going to play off the OEM. Right before this interview that we're doing here, I had a partner pull me aside and he said to me, Ed, I want to be on stage with you next year talking about all the success and you in a security company that he's got product security embedding OEM agents and whatnot in his application. So I'm looking forward to between now and next year, we're going to build roadmap, we're going to keep delivering everything, but I'm looking forward to celebrating all of the agent use cases that we've then delivered for our customers. We are, the pump is primed, our customers are ready to go. They did hands-on labs. I heard a story yesterday, Manny Gill, who I think was on with you yesterday.
He did
a hands-on lab, and when folks walked in the room, he said the room was packed. He asked how many people have built an agent. He said three hands were raised. We walked the packed room through building agents, and at the end he said, okay, now how many have built an agent? And everybody's hand went up. So we are enabling an army of agent builders. Next year, just looking forward to celebrating like all of the solutions we see come to life on the technology. So
that's cool. Awesome. Can't wait to see that tell that story. Ed, thank you so much for coming, always. One of our favorite longtime guests. And thank you, Paul. Thank all of you, wherever you might be. We're here in Dallas, Texas at Boomi World 2025. My name's Savannah Peterson. You're watching theCUBE, the leading source for enterprise tech news.